Welcome to another Shadow of War preview video. The Nemesis system is what makes Shadow of War special. The Overlords, Warchiefs and Captains are all unique, both in the way they look and in the way they behave. Both of these aspects are influenced by the tribe, race and their strengths and weaknesses. And that's what we'll talk about today. The how and what of the strengths and weaknesses, how they work, since they have changed pretty significantly since Shadow of Mordor. Before starting, we want to explain how the strengths and weaknesses work. When selecting an Overlord, Warchief or Captain, in the top left you can see four icons that are strengths and four that are weaknesses. From left to right, these are the immunities, hates, which means they become enraged, class traits, think of tribe traits, class traits, and race bonuses. And finally, bonuses. Then moving on to weaknesses, we have mortal weaknesses, vulnerabilities, dazed by, and hints. The hints are essentially when a captain gets damaged by something. Let's just take a few captains as examples. Let's start with the strengths. For this, we'll use Mr. Scott as our example. In the immunity section, you can see that he has an ability that is called Poison Proof, which makes him immune to poison attacks. Moving on to the hates category, you can see he will become enraged by mortal wounds, that's to say when his health is very low. And he also has Bestial Frenzy, which enrages him after killing a beast. Following this are the class traits. As you can see, this is where most of the benefits are. You can see the advanced class trait, multiple other class traits like Furious Charge, Rabbit and Rampage. And besides this, he can also have a tribe bonus, as he is from the Mystic tribe. It's called Mystic Blade. And the final perk we can notice is the class bonus, which gives him a crossbow. And the final category, bonuses, holds a cursed weapon bonus, which means he wields a blighted weapon capable of cursing his enemies. Moving on to the weaknesses, we'll use this grumpy old fucker here on screen, Ogg the Elder. In the category mortal weaknesses, you can see he has his fears for morrow flies and grouts. Sadly, he has nothing to show for in the vulnerabilities category, but here you can expect things like vulnerable to fire or something. In the dazed by category, you can see his literal Achilles heel, like Michael the Plotter so eloquently said, is that he has a fear of pinning. And finally, in the hints category, you this time see some more weaknesses, like the fact that he is vulnerable to ranged attacks, is damaged by explosions, and damaged by stealth attacks. So there's a lot of bonuses and non-bonuses, so weaknesses, that can affect a captain, and they're divided in these eight categories. That's actually all there is for the strengths and weaknesses. This video is mainly to give an overview of how the strengths and weaknesses work with a short example. In the upcoming episode, we will take a look at the different classes and traits that come along with it. So essentially the third from the left for the strengths. Thank you for watching, and we'll hopefully see you in the upcoming video. Later!